Hello, I'm EnterElysium. Welcome back to Stellaris, patch 1.3 Heinlein, with the Leviathans expansion. Right, we are playing as the Geck Collective, and we've just discovered the Commonwealth of Valsho, who have instantly closed their borders, like Britain, and are just sitting there, taunting us. We need to murder them, or at least, you know, we're going to try and be friends, because we went into space with going, oh, look, we are going to find some friends. And then we come across these people who are instantly like, no, we hate you. I mean, partly they hate us because we grabbed Arrakis, and they were like, Arrakis should be ours. And I'm like, define ours. By that, do you mean mine? Yes. So, yeah, let's continue on. Joy, oh, joy, oh, joy. I believe the patch actually does come out tomorrow to the general public, so look out for that one. You're still surveying. You're surveying. We are building our second... No, we're not. Yeah, we're going to build our second colony ship. We're saving up for it. A large amount of ship debris can be found in orbit around this planet, possibly the remnants of some kind of massive fleet action. 30%? We'll do it. Why not? Let's splash out. Now, we also really want to grab Merop. However, unfortunately, we kind of pissed off an angry couple. And that's kind of blocking us. What do we finish on the surface? Good setup. How are we doing for food? We've got 4. Nice. We're still growing down here. Okay, we're in a decent position. We've got plenty of energy. Really want to get this system. Signs of battle. There's clear evidence that a massive space battle took place. We've looked through for derelict technologies, etc. Blah, blah, blah.
Situation log updated.
Scientist skill 2 has skill 3 or higher. Okay, so I need a skill through or higher scientist to actually do that. Okay. Get more experience quickly. I want to learn about the derelict shipyards and all their jazz. So it's not a shipyard, it's a derelict fleet, I guess. Imdol. You have leveled up. Maybe we should use you. We'd have to go through the angry couple. I mean, we can go past them really easily. It's a shame. Also, hyperdrives have been massively nerfed in this patch. The patch notes finally came out in full form. And you can no longer hyperdrive from inside a system. You have to go to the edge of the gravity well, just like every other FTL means in the game. But that really does nerf hyperdrives. So, like, that's why they were super fast. Like, they were fast traveling, but they were also fast because you didn't have to go to the edge of a system. You could just jump out. So, I don't know really what their advantage is now. I mean, they're slightly faster, but the limiting to node is actually terrible. Like I said, I'm only playing hyperdrives in this playthrough because they're the one we haven't played. I wouldn't play them as a first choice. Found. Strong energy emissions from an unknown origin. Okay, let's do that. 22% chance of failure. Having for minerals. Getting there. Oh. No source of the strange animations coming from where they were found. Okay. Well, that was somewhat anticlimactic.
System survey complete. System survey complete.
Come on,
research
one more month.
Complete.
Ooh. Ion thruster. Not bad. Let's do space torpedoes, because once we unlock space torpedoes, we actually should get the torpedo slot for our ship, so we'll do that. By the way, part of the reason that it now is the torpedo goes in the torpedo slot is because everyone was like, yeah, why should I use missiles? Torpedoes are just better. Admittedly, the weapons in the game originally were particularly well balanced, so I'm glad that they've took that on board. However, I'm not sure how slots are going to work out. It might just be a case of, right, everyone should get these whenever they come available. But at least they're no longer replacing our things. Right, we've got iron thrusters, so we should update our ship designs. There we go. Save. Save. And transport ship. By the way, editable transport ships was something I requested because you couldn't upgrade the warp drive on your transport ships. And it meant that your transport ships just couldn't do certain things, and you couldn't actually leave systems to go elsewhere in some cases. I said, you know, could they be editable? And they said, yeah, that would be a great stopgap. You're meant to be a stopgap. Why are you still here? Yeah, I mean, it works fine. Don't get me wrong. But, I'm also not sure if, like, the AI actually takes account of the fact that it can actually design its own transport ships. Because, you know, you could just design them to have shields and stuff on board, like I tend to do. Because, you know, why shouldn't you? But I'm not sure the AI does that, because it was never really designed to be used that way. Poto has leveled up. That would be you. In which case, I want you to come back here. Or here. I can't remember where the... Where was it? Right. Habitable world survey, precursor debris, track. Trace of... that's helpful. None of those are really useful for me. But anyway. Right, go to here. Potato, boil and mash and put them in a stew. Poto! Research. But then you can go back to surveying that system.
Anomaly found.
5%. Outset regions do not match simulated projections. Do it. Also, I've completely skipped the fact that I was meant to be doing a colony ship. Whoopsie. I will grab another Corvette first, because the Corvette is a lot quicker to do. And I kind of want to make sure that our fleet is buffed, because we're down to 3 ships in our fleet at the moment, and that is just not good enough. And then we'll be able to build a colony ship afterwards. Ooh! Shadow play, +6 society research. That is really nice. Seriously, shadow play is one of the really awesome things. If you can get that early... that means that you can be like, yeah, by the way, my society research just doubled
ships
or something.
Upgraded. Construction complete.
Notice how quickly it is to build, like, Corvettes. You might as well upgrade as well, I guess.
Research complete.
What do we research? Propaganda broadcasts. And increase the monthly influence. Ooh! Frontier collectives. History has proven collectives to be the most efficient social structure for settler enclaves. Resettlement cost goes down, colony development speed goes up. You know what? I'll do it, but mostly just because it's a rare. And I've never had it before. I don't think I've actually ever seen that one.
System survey complete.
It could be new, or it could just be, you know, something I missed, but I don't recall seeing it in any tech trees or anything I've looked at. So maybe it is new. That said, there is a lot of new stuff in this patch, so it's throwing me a little bit. Fusion reactor, lovely. Right. Sensors, physics lab. Power. I kind of think we want to do this, but I'm not sure if that's the thing we want to do, like, first of all. Service speed plus 50% is actually going to be really helpful. Yeah, we'll do that.
Special project complete.
Ooh. Experience, a load of engineering research. I would do for engineering research now. 17 months remaining. Okay. Oh, hello. Verzak civilization encounter. We've detected the presence of a pre-space civilization in the industrial era. Okay. Interesting. I mean, not that there's any planets up here for us to really take advantage of, which is a shame. because I kind of want to get hold of that. But oh well. I mean, we could put down a, like, a frontier station. That'd be insane. We could get the society research from studying this civilization and the society research from this if we... I don't know if the blob would be enough. But that would be incredibly powerful.
System survey complete.
There is nothing else in that system. That civilization, when they get to space, are going to be really disappointed. Colony ship's nearly done. Awesome, right. Colony ship. Do all the colony things. Where do we need to go? Well, we can't go up here. There's actually nothing down here. I mean, as much as I'd like to go to Belgium, I don't think that's really within our realm of feasibility at the moment. So we'll go over here and we'll grab the 22 Alpine. Yes. It's got two blockers next to it. If we go down here... It's got two energy. Ooh, be a good energy world. Yeah, we'll go here.
Ships upgraded. Construction complete. System survey complete.
Right, let's start building up a few more corvettes for now. Yeah, we're losing energy credits because we've set up another colony. That's fine. Goes with the territory.
System survey complete.
Right. Meanwhile, we've kind of ignored our infrastructure for a little bit. So what I'm thinking is we grab... mining station.
Construction complete.
Life signs! Do it! 50% chance of failure. What happens if it's a 50% chance? Do you, like, accidentally ingest the new life form? You'd be like, whoopsie, I accidentally shot and killed and then cooked and then ate this delicious kangaroo. Silicon life forms. Ooh. Which gives us minerals, because presumably we go, look, we can harvest these life forms. And then make them into our hut. Ooh, hello. Another industrial era. Okay. They've got a nice system here. I mean, not that I know what's here, but it is a busy system. That's what I mean. Again, not really a world we're interested in.
Construction complete.
Proto-civilization. Ooh, Neolithic Master 5 developed a rudimentary... We're discovering all the aliens today.
Anomaly found.
7%.
Research complete.
Weird writing. Okay. And that is space torpedoes. We're going to do improved spaceports so that we can get towards getting the one up from destroyers. The one up from corvettes. Right. Let's have a look at what we've just unlocked, because we've just unlocked torpedoes. And I kind of want to have some torpedoes. Torpedo boat. There we go. Which is one torpedo slot and then one small slot. Now, is that actually worth it? Let's look at you. You do quite a lot of damage. Cooldown is... Wow! 20 second cooldown. Right, so the average damage, the DPS, is basically double. Missile, evasion 10%, hull points 2, speed 5, 205. But this one has 100% shield penetration and a fusion missile doesn't? I mean, presumably a fusion missile and a space torpedo do sort of the same thing. I'm not sure why one can penetrate shields and one can't. And I'm not a fan of things that can penetrate shields when you're, like, mixing and matching, because then it's like, well, some of them's going to be hitting the shield and going to be used normally, and the other one of them's going to be penetrating the shield. You might as well go all one way or all the other. That said, it does have a longer range. No, it doesn't actually. The fusion missile actually has a longer range. Tracking 0%, accuracy 100. I don't know what tracking 0% means when it's got accuracy 100. I honestly kind of feel that space torpedoes might actually not be the best thing now. And actually, instead of might not be the best thing, I mean actually might just be kind of meh. They don't have a long range. Their average damage is a little over double. But it comes at the price of point defense can easily shoot them down. So for now, I guess we will actually use the torpedo boat. With the proviso that as soon as enemies are around, we're going to switch out. And autocomplete design. That is a lot of energy. And we don't actually need that much. We just need that much. It looks like a little face, like Wally or something. Little eyes, little ears. Alright, save that. Yes. And upgrade. Ooh. An expensive upgrade. Okay. Colony's gonna be good soon. Alien writing. More society research. Because of course we need more society research. You know what? We should actually just put a station up here and then just get the ridiculous amounts of society research and just be like, yeah, look, we're basically sociologists. That is entire nation. We are gecko sociologists. You know, we have all the society research. We don't know about physics or engineering. But, like, sociology? Yeah. I mean, it's not research. Because it's not society research, because it also covers stuff like, you know, biology and genetics and stuff. I guess it's more, like, how it applies to society. I don't know. But it covers, basically, it's biology. That's what I'm saying. Engineering is kind of more to do with chemistry than it is to do with physics, sort of. Because this is actually definitely physics. So I guess this is maybe chemistry? Because, you know, getting the right alloys and stuff, maybe chemistry. I mean, when you're talking about chemistry, if we're talking about like really advanced chemistry, chemistry is basically physics. Physics is basically math. Biology becomes chemistry. It's a good old joke when you get to university level. Science ship, you're actually done down here. Ooh, maybe we should do some more. Oh, we could do some upgrading. Oh, that would involve sending you home. And I can't be bothered, so what we're going to do is just going to tell you to do more research. There you go, have fun. Construction ship, meh. You're getting pretty tough at the moment, actually. I think we could almost take you. Yeah, no, we're actually stronger than them. We could take down the angry couple. I think we should get, like, maybe one more corvette at least. Possibly two before we do so. Otherwise, you know, we'll beat them, but we'll have, like, no one left. It'll be like a pirate victory. Construction complete. Anomaly. Energy readings from this planet might be a glitch. But we should check it out. Do it. I mean, for a 50% chance of failure. Okay, one more month. It's been 1 month since I went to space. 1 month since the four giant space cows. What do we get? Three physics research. Great. 7% chance. Life signs. Sure, do it. Unemployment? I forgot. You rapidly breed. I can't afford to do anything. Sorry. I guess matching where we could just about afford to get rid of a tile blocker. Yeah, let's free up this one.
Construction complete.
Right. Actually got quite a decent navy this stage in the game. Silicon life forms. At this stage, we're just like, are all life forms outside of us, you know, silicon? I mean, apart from the Commonwealth of Valshow. There are signs of activity by ancient precursor civilization. Research it. Proto-civilization. They've discovered fire and stuff. Good for them, I guess. Batharian stone! We need to research Poseidon Stone. Poseidon Stone is amazing. Right. Ilse, you can do this. I believe in you. Right, take down the space cows.
System survey complete.
They need to die. Ooh, derelict Erassian ship.
Situation log updated.
Yeah, you're definitely researching that. We definitely want to find out about this derelict, highly advanced ship. That just happens to be here. Yeah, we're not letting that go past. Right. By the way, we're looking pretty awesome. Okay, space cows.
Fleet engaged.
Missiles, then torpedoes. A little bit closer. There we go, torpedoes. Okay, yeah, you're going down. You want to remember to, abandon ship at the right point. Not too early. Them space cows. No! Okay, we're down a corvette. Come on, you can kill them. Kill the space cows. Is that a dead space cow? It's close! They keep regenerating! So tough to kill them. Stop regenerating. Yeah, finally. Okay. Right, now this one. Are you going to be even angrier because we killed your mate? Maybe that should be a thing. Maybe they should have a special thing that triggers to be I'm super angry. Rage. Rage. They should rage. Like barbarians in D&D, they should get a plus 2 damage at level 1. Okay, come on. Meanwhile, while that battle goes on. By the way, if you're actually one of the crewmen on these ships, this battle's been going on for 2 months? No, not 2 months, because we're on single speed. So it's been going on for several weeks. You must be getting pretty tired by now. Yeah, you're unemployed. Move over here, then you'll actually be employed, mate. And then we'll build you a coupler, which we can't do. We'll wait a few more days. We'll build this power plant to celebrate our coming victory. Our coming victory, I mean the one that takes place half a month after I build it. Right, go home and heal. It was a great victory, but most importantly, we now have an amazing kick-ass system. We also would like you to finish the derelict cruiser and then immediately come home.
Construction complete.
Yeah, okay, we've got some more things. Archaeological project complete. We gained an Erassian artifact and 61 engineering. Really? Just 61 engineering? 61 engineering isn't very much. Definitely make sure you sever this system ASAP. It's a pretty good system. Not gonna lie. That is a system that everyone wants in their dreams and hopes, and quite frankly, I do. Ooh, Abaddon's Demence. Oh, that just doesn't sound good. It's the Eye of Terror. I really want to nickname that the Eye of Terror. Right, okay. I've been EnterElysium. We're gonna end the episode here today. If you've enjoyed, please do remember to like. If you're not subscribed, consider subscribing. Also, consider hitting the little bell icon next to subscribe so you're actually notified of new videos, because otherwise it can defeat the purpose of subscribing in the first place. But what do I know? I just work here. But anyway, until next time, when we'll continue to build up our military, make them a little bit tougher. We've defeated the space cows, so obviously once you've defeated the space cows, the next step is defeat the space... What are you? foxes, which makes strange sense. That did not sound like a fox sound, but then again, you are an alien. Also, your leader has changed. I think your leader is cuter now. We're going to have a cute off. It'll be, how cute are we? Oh, well, God, no, not you. You're just some sort of weird social tyrannid.
Oh, we are the Geckos. We are the cutest.
We are the space foxes. I don't know what space foxes sound like, but they make some sort of weird grunting sound when I... Listen. That was a bit more like what I'd... Anyway, once we have our queued off, we will defeat them, we will enslave the population, and we will win. But until then, stay shiny.